So this is continuation of lecture number 19, and in this particular part of the lecture I will discuss about the VOC, that is the open circuit voltage of a solar panel, and the ISC, or the short circuit current of a solar panel. The open circuit voltage is the maximum voltage that a solar panel can produce. That is a condition when there is no load on it. That is measured with a multimeter across the open ends of the wires that are attached to the panel. The voltage is generally highest in mid and mornings and afternoon as the sun rises rapidly, and the panel temperature should be quite low. As the silicon is the semiconductor device and most of the solar panels are made out of it, and silicon has a negative temperature coefficient, means that the resistance will be increasing with increase in temperature. So as the solar panels tend to get hot, its efficiency will be reduced significantly. The next is the short circuit current. The short circuit current is the current through the solar cell when the voltage across the solar cell is zero, means that it has been short circuited. The wires that are coming out of the solar panel, they are to be short circuit for the measurement of this short circuit current. For an ideal solar cell at most a moderate resistive loss mechanism, the short circuit current and the light generated current that was discussed in the previous slide, they are identical. The short circuit current is measured by the shortening of output terminals under full illumination condition, means that the sun is at its full intensity. The open circuit voltage is at when the current is zero, ignoring the short ISH given by the formula VOC equals AKT divided by Q multiplied by natural log of IL by ID plus 1. The term KT by Q has a value of 0.026 volts at the temperature of 300 kelvins. IL is many times the diode current, diode saturation current. Therefore the VOC, or the open circuit voltage, is many times 0.026 volts. As I discussed earlier, these cells have negative temperature coefficient, means that the resistance decreases as the temperature will tend to increase. The next is the IV characteristic of the solar panel. The solar cell IV characteristic show the current and the voltage characteristic of a particular photovoltaic cell. It can be a module or an array. Given a detailed description of the solar energy conversion, and its ability and efficiency can be determined through the by looking at these types of curve. Knowing the electrical IV characteristics, more importantly the maximum power, I will discuss it in the next slide, of a solar cell or a solar panel is critically determined for the devices for approximating their optimum performance efficiency. The solar cell IV characteristic curve are basically a graphical representation of operation of a solar cell or a module. So it summarizes the relationship between the current and voltage at the existing conditions of radiance and temperature. The IV characteristics or IV curves provide the information that is required to configure a solar system so that it can operate as close as possible to its optimal peak performance point, that is MPP, maximum power point. The graph shows the IV characteristics, this graph of a typical silicon photovoltaic cell operating under normal conditions. The power delivered by a solar cell is the product of the current and the voltage, that is why it is known as IV curve. The multiplication, if done, the point for point for all the voltages from there are two main points, the short circuit point and the open circuit condition, in which basically the short circuit current in which the negative and positive terminals are short circuited, and in open circuit condition no load is connected and the voltage is measured for the solar cell for maximum sunlight. In the presence of maximum sunlight, the power curve is obtained for a given radiation level. Let me show you the power curve. This is the power curve. With the solar cell open circuited, it is not connected to any load. The current will be at its minimum, that is close to zero, and the voltage across the cell is maximum. This is known as the open circuit point, and at this point VOC or the open circuit voltage is measured. At the other extreme, when the solar cell is short circuited, that is the positive and negative leads are connected together, the voltage across the cell is minimum, because the short circuit it is at the voltage is at zero, but the current flowing out of the cell reaches its maximum value, and we named it as ISE or the I short circuit. However, there is one particular combination for that is P max. This is the P max at the knee point. It is measured as I maximum point, and the product of I maximum and V maximum. In other words, it is a point at which the cell or the photovoltaic cell is capable of generating maximum electrical power, and this is shown on the top right area. This is the maximum power point or the MPP. Therefore, the ideal operation of a photovoltaic cell is defined to be at the maximum power point. The maximum power point is of a solar cell is positioned near the bend of the IV characteristic curve or the PV characteristic curve. The corresponding values of maximum voltage and the maximum current for that will be capable of generating maximum power can be estimated from an open circuit voltage and the short circuit voltage, the short circuit current. The maximum voltage point is around 0.8, I guess, and the 0.85 for I and 0.85 is also for current. Under these conditions, the area under the curve will be giving the maximum value, so that is the knee point, and at that point maximum power can be generated. The cell behaves like a constant current source in the left shaded region and matches the generated voltage to the to load resistors. And cell behaves like a constant voltage source in the right shaded region. The knee point lies between the shaded region. If the reverse voltage is applied to a cell, that is mainly done under the fault to test the fault condition, it absorbs power and it keeps on absorbing the power up till the cell breakdown, that is the cell breakdown point. The current increases sharply after the breakdown point. In the dark, the cell current remains nearly zero up to the cell breakdown region. So in practical scenarios, the cell is operated slightly to the left of the P maximum point, power point, and it is modeled as a constant current source for the purpose of electrical analysis.